Welcome back into more Lost Odyssey for the Xbox 360. Let's see, I forget where we're going, actually. Let me go see. Everything's up and running. Bring up chat here. I want to thank everybody who's been supporting on YouTube or Twitch, however you choose to watch any of my gaming content or any of my content at all. Really appreciate it. You guys are just odd. The support lately has been incredible, as always, really. I mean, some of you have been watching me for years, somehow. All right, let's continue this journey. I don't know. So I don't know where we're going. I kind of forget. But we're going to figure it out. Oh, here we go. The cook's over here to tell us. Thank you, Cookie. Cook, whatever her name is. The monster show. Crimson Forest is in the mountains to the west. Alright. Mountains to the west. So do we have to like leave here and then travel via the map screen? Ew. Maybe up here? No, oh, this is where the ceremony was. Of course. Let's go back. I really love this game. I feel like we've done so much already and we're still on the first disc. Like, there's gonna be quite a few moments of brilliance, I think, in this game. We'll see. I think we're just gonna go back to the map screen. That's what it feels like. Oh. Ring my bell. Oh, we're getting a memory already. Here we go, let's all read. Dream has been revealed. Let's get it going. Perfect. Sip of my drink here. Evening bell. Oh, he was a farmer, huh? I don't care if you're from the moon. Guns of the Hellcast says the memory lures for Kaim are the best. There's some really good ones so far. They're kind of like, you know, a little like their own little stories within the story. Tells you more about all the experiences he's been through, of course. It's really cool. And welcome into the stream. this will go to the sky to see where God turns God. Death has he seen in this endlessly long life of his. She wants her ashes scattered on this field where she spent so much time, it seems like. Underrated. It seems like it. This is my first time playing it. This is really good. It's been recommended to me by viewers, you know. I mean, I'd heard of the game, but I didn't know much about it. But people that watch me were saying, you gotta play Lost Odyssey. I said, alright. And it's, yeah, it's living up to the hype so far. Really good. I just have to watch all the ones that I've been watching. 10 years from now. Ring my bell. Signaling the end of the workday. He has no right to live there. Yeah, I heard the last story is also good. That one's on the Wii, right? I think it's pretty expensive. I'd like to check that game out someday, too. Hey, hello, Mitsa. How are you doing? How's your weekend? The Wanderer. Actually, that was the shortest dream yet. Alright. Let's keep it going. With that super speed. Yeah, on the Wii. Yeah, that one looks really good. Because the Wii doesn't have a lot of RPGs at all. That's probably why it's so expensive. That's good, I'm glad you're doing well. Not bad, not bad. Hanging in there. Now what? Oh boy.
You know war is a terrorist job. Apparently not.
Wait, what was that? Let's save it here. Letters? No, I have not gotten that one yet. I don't remember that one anyways. That does not dredge up a memory for me. How many have we... Actually, it tells you how much ones you've gotten. Right, dreams. Got letters, huh? No. These are the ones we have so far. So I have to go to the mountains now? Or is this bring me? Oh, here we go. Yeah, Crimson Forest. That's right. That's where we go. Is there a... There's a shop in Numara, right? So, did I... I don't know if I went shopping. Well, we're gonna go. I think I bought some stuff last time I played. That looks like the Lost Woods or something. So basically, we're in Akihari Forest in Japan. This place is definitely haunted then. Alright, let's go. This is nice. Yeah. Lots of changes of scenery in this game. That's another thing I really appreciate in RPGs, when they give you a lot of different towns and different locations to check out. Always nice to see the change. I think we're gonna get in some battles here, yeah? Crystal fragment. Let's see what we're fighting here. Cook's there. She's like on the team now. Now let's do. Now what items do I? Oh, I don't have a lot of items anymore. What happened? I have some wind bombs, aqua bombs. So I got some stuff. I'll do. Prism. What can she do? Hey. Let's see if he can just attack one of these. None of them are dead yet. Gosh damn. Alright, that one's dead finally. Oh, that did nothing. Oh, we gotta heal Kaim. Actually, I'll just have him attack. And I'll have somebody else heal him. Have her attack. What the heck? Alright, good. No, 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 no. Let's attack this punk. Everybody attack! Oh, that was bad. That was really bad. He's doing damage to us, though. I see every time I hit him. That's alright. Nice one, Jansen. Nice! Yeah, he can just do... I'll just have him defend. I'll heal him. Oh, there we go. Jansen and Cook leveled up. Good. So we're not going that way. How about what's this? But I'll just have him attack this one. I'll have her attack that one too. He's gonna do Prism. And then she can do covers HP of one party member, Prayer. Oh, I'll have her do that for Kaim. Die, bug. They look like stick bugs or something. There we go. About nap time for Seth. I don't think she can do anything because she's asleep, right? Zephyr. She's definitely like a support character here. Not much for attacking. I'll also have her like keep healing people. Yeah. Come on. Yeah, Jansen. All right. He's gonna do. See, I don't know, like, what. Hang on, what type of. So he's element water, so fire should hurt him, I would assume. Oh, he's dead now. We won't find out. Nice. Good job, squad. What is this? Nothing. Kick the mushrooms. Another crystal fragment. Whoa, oh! Well, that was a nice surprise. Kind of like when I pick up a rock on the ground or something. You lift up like a piece of firewood and there's a spider under it. That's a nice surprise. Alright, we're just gonna go strong here. We'll have him do prism. And we'll have her do. Don't be. This is like the snake thing all over again, stealing their power. Oh, man. Okay, I think we need to get some water spells on these pools. Don't kill Seth! Alright, that's, I guess, okay. Punk. Alright. That spell. Aqua. Let's kill like one of these things. And he's gonna heal Seth. Thanks for the follow, Guns of the Hellcast. I appreciate that. You punk. Come on. Let's get him. Alright, water. Oh gosh. Another time, get rid of this. He'll do Zephyr. Good enough. Nice. Prism. Oh, I just healed everybody. Come on. I guess I'll do it with him now. Right, if he can do. That. Prism again? What? What? What are you doing, Final Fantasy 16? Oh yeah, I heard that's awesome. I played a little bit of the demo. Fortunately, I don't have a PS5, so I can't buy it. Looks really good. How are you enjoying that one? I think I gotta kill this thing, right? I gotta kill this thing straight up before it kills us. Still alive? No! It's gonna kill us! Our progress is gone. Holy shit. I underestimated that thing. Why was it so strong? Let's see if we can retry it. We got wrecked, Mita. By a bug. Alright, well, we're here. We have to go through the forest again. I guess we'll just go the same way we went. Supposed to go. I'm not kicking that freaking stone again, I can tell you that much. I'll do this in case I have to do this. Alright, let's not kick the stones. I was already Mac ran in here, I completely forgot. To try and see his mother again. This farce is about as fantasy as it gets, the music and everything. Colors. Freaking things. Now I'm gonna go right after him. Whoops. Oh, it's wind. So what hurts wind? Is it ground? Fire? Oh, okay, thank you. Casting support so we can get Prism off. Gosh. Some early damage there. That's one still alive. Yeah, okay, we gotta do fire. Alright, I'm gonna do player now. At this point. Nice. Huge explosion. That was a public friggin' set off the Oppenheimer bomb. Again.
Are you some kind of beast?
Oh gosh. Right, spell. This is gonna be hard, all right, then. Prism. Let's go, team. Come on. Oh, he's out of here. All right. Man, I need to heal everybody. Oh, yeah. That did good damage. Attack. She's gonna do Zephyr. He's also gonna do Zephyr. Oh, good. Alright, now we can spend some turns healing. Level 17 already. Very nice, very nice. Sure. I don't have a lot of healing. Here. Hopefully there's a save point soon. Oh, there's one right here. Nice. Sorcerer's Shrine. Was this like an Indiana Jones thing? Freaking thing. Can't push it from that side. And now I can't push it at all. I don't know. Push it. I can't push it any direction. Is it stuck? Hopefully, I don't need that. Is there anything too important? Needed to break something? Does it like hopefully like resets if I need it? Prism as well as him. So strong, holy crap. Are you kidding me? Alright. I don't have much left. I'm gonna have to just like attack normally. She can do right now to help. I guess heal him. So strong. Holy, this does like 400 damage. What do I do here against this? get like magic defense. Well, too much for that. ...671 damage. What? How do you even... I need to get a magic barricade up first. Oh my gosh, why is like... the regular little enemies like wrecking me? It's bad enough the boss fights are... like, super hard. Some of like the little enemies can just destroy you. Like the minion ones. There's like three of them in a battle. And any one of them can kill you. Let's go down. I don't think I'm pushing it into the hole, am I? Controls on this are so weird. Like, sometimes he just stops pushing for no reason. Come on. What the heck? I don't know. More thus, the beginning of the game is more difficult, Mitsa. Yeah, it's very hard opening to this game. That's with some RPGs, right? And then once you get like leveled up and more powerful, it becomes a little bit more smoother. So I'll see once we reach like level like 22 or something like that. What's up, Iowa? Welcome in, dude. I don't. Alright, I'm done playing with this rock. I don't know what you can do. The controls on that are so weird. I can't get it to go anywhere I'm trying to get it to go. Hopefully we don't have to do anything with that rock. They did not... those kind of whack controls. Hit. Alright. Oh shoot, run! Oh gosh, what? What was that? You chilling? That's good, that's good. We are too. Despite getting bolder down here. And look at that guy. I guess he hasn't seen the Indiana Jones films, no? He definitely has not. Alright. I can't do much with him because I don't have a lot of... What happened to his other attack? I do that, and continue that. Resurrect! Oh, come on. Let's kill this thing. He's Earth, so... Wind? Have him do Zephyr. This is like 483 damage. That's great. We are in trouble. Do wind again on him. We got his Zephyr. She's got his Zephyr. Charging again. Hey Dev, thanks for the sub, man. 23 months, almost 2 years, dude. Yeah? Thank you so much, Dev. Dev has been sub to me since I went to affiliation. Yeah, we're almost there. September or something will be... So one more month will be pretty much be 2 years. Thank you, Dev. I appreciate that, man. Sip of that zero. Okay. We need to kill this bad boy right now. These stupid things. Doesn't do anything. Physical attacks are no good on him. Well, Cook's dead. What did you pre-order today? I don't have anything. Alright, you can just... heal. Whatever, I don't know. Don't kill her. Two damage, nice. Oh, we almost got him. This again. We have to use so much magic points here. Almost dead. you are ready for Mortal Kombat 1. It's kind of weird that they're making it 1, but the premium edition. Does that have, like, that doesn't have any, like, figures or anything with it. It just probably has all the DLC that you'll get with that one. It's kind of weird that they're, like, rebooting Mortal Kombat, but I guess they felt like they needed, you know, I needed to change that. Where is this bringing me? Use that, and then I'll give her an item to get back her mana. Anson as well. Kaim. There. Now we got a little bit more. Gotta make it to that save point. Do I travel on this thing? Gosh damn it. Where do I go? Peacemaker. Wait, like from like John Cena's character from that DC movie? Mortal Kombat always adds in like crazy characters. This sucks. What do I do? Even like walking slowly doesn't do anything. I think I have to like run. Go, use that super speed. Yep. Super speed finally came in handy. Yeah, that character. Okay, that's actually kind of cool. I didn't. Oh my gosh. What is the point of this, too? I mean, we made it. Let's see. Oh, actually, there's a. Let's get the healing thing. There we go. Okay. Alan Wake 2 is only digital, yeah. Unfortunately, but still gonna, I mean, obviously I'm gonna buy the game. I'm still trying to wrap my head around buying digital stuff. Yeah, that's a big boo. Like, I don't know why they're claiming it's because, oh, we can release the game in a better state because if it's digital, they don't have to make the copies and like ship it when it's not ready. So then just how about ship the game physically when it's actually ready? Like, why don't companies do that anymore? They're like, so if there's anything that they need to fix, like, last second, they can do it. It's like, that's what they're claiming, anyways. And they're saying that, oh, it keeps us from having to put the game at $70. I don't know about that either. I think maybe they just don't want to print the physical copies because they don't want to spend the money to do it. Even though, like, a lot of people are gonna want them. Like, And there's this new thing coming out of Ubisoft now, where Ubisoft's saying if you're active on your account, they can take away some of your games or something, like your Ubisoft games that you bought digitally, or like, because like, oh, you weren't playing or you're not active on it, so it's our, like, you, people that think digital is the only way to go aren't realizing some of the things that the companies are going to be able to control now. Like, they're going to be able to say, you don't own our game at all. We own it. We're allowing you to access it. That's what it is. You heard about the Ubisoft thing? It sucks. Yeah, it's just so stupid. It's going to hurt them. It's like, that's what I'm worried about. You're not actually going to own your games anymore. You're just going to buy access to them. And then whenever they say, oh, it's shut down or we're changing it, or they're going to be able to take it away. Fuck Ubisoft. There we go. That's their voice heard here. Gonzaga, it's stupid. It's really stupid. It's like, I'm not against digital gaming at all. Like, I get it. I understand it. Games should be available digitally. I bought some digital games. I'm going to buy some. But to take away the physical option so that we don't own it anymore is really sad. People can say, oh, you know, physical is no different. You're just getting an access key on the disc, and to a certain extent, yes, not the whole game is printed on the disc anymore, we all know that, but it's the fact that you can own it, you can access it whenever you want by having this key or, you know, this code. For digital, it's just like, yeah, you have this unlock, but they can take it away whenever they want. Same thing with like a streaming service like Stadia or something, whatever, you know, even Game Pass, you know, great stuff, but whatever they want to take a certain game off, you know, they take it off. You don't own it. You can't just play it whenever you want to. So that's why I always prefer to actually physically own games if I can. But it's hard. It's hard now. We're in that transition where things are going to be digital only. So it is going to be hard to determine whether or not you actually own a game anymore. It's annoying. And companies are getting more and more greedy about it. Like the Ubisoft thing is so stupid. Like, if you buy a game, you should own it. You should be able to play it whenever the hell you want to without a company saying, oh, you're not playing it right now? Or, oh, we're going to shut down the service. Like these live services shut down games or make it so you have to play a game at specific times. It's just different. When you grew up in a different era where gaming was just like you pop it in, you play the game. You know, even this, a game like this, I can throw this in my 360, play this game, you know, 10, 15, 20 years from now. Some games today, you won't be able to do that. And yes, physical stuff does break down over time, so I think preserving games digitally is a good thing. You know, that's a good thing as well. So it leaves you an opportunity to play these games in the future for people that, you know, didn't grow up in certain areas. So, you know, we could go on and on all night about it. You guys know there's pros and cons to everything, but it's hard to see past the greed of some of these companies with all the monetization and everything. They want to own it, control it all, you know, so you don't own your games, because like I said, digital games only are gonna stay higher priced too. Why? Because without physical games, there's nobody trading them in. That secondhand value isn't there anymore. So if there's no physical copies of a game like Alan Wake 2, they can keep that game at $60 for as long as they want. But if it goes physical, people trade it in, people play it, people beat it, physical copies going around at conventions, yard sales, whatever, that's naturally going to drop the price of the game and it's going to go on sale. But now, you know, even a game like Redfall right now still is not dropping in price because there aren't that many physical copies floating around there. People are selling them on like eBay, but I haven't seen any in stores before. You know, I'm waiting to get Redfall when it goes on sale, but it's not going on sale because they're owning that price. And be like, oh, we're going to keep this at $70, $65 because screw you, you know. It's not going to go on sale. Not for a while still. That's the problem. Things will not go on sale as much. They can keep them at full price, however they damn well please. Digital's cleaner. Digital's less, you know, stuff to have and move around or whatever. for sure. But, man, if something happens to your account or something, your account gets hacked, you're gonna lose stuff that you had purchased. Gotta fight these fools again. At least we know what works on him. Just gonna take him out. I said it's each their own with digital physical. I'm kind of leaning towards a hybrid of both because that's what we have to do, you know? Some people may not buy games at all in the future if it's digital only. And I can understand that. Like I said to people, I'm going to just print my own boxes or something for games so I at least have them on my shelf in some sense. Even if I don't physically own them. Let's just keep attacking him. Like, Alan Wake 2 will be the first, like, new digital game that I buy in a long time. In a long, long time. Am I gonna print my own box for it? Probably, I'm gonna try to anyways. But I mean, I still think that it's gonna get a physical release eventually. Like, not right away, but I think like Remedy, you know, Remedy might be like, it will really suck. And Remedy's like, oh yeah, like a year they're gonna print physical copies. So then like, people like me are gonna rebuy the game because they're gonna want it physically, right? So they're gonna get extra money. I feel like that's what they're trying to do. I don't want to be like super cynical, but the way companies are these days. Or, you know, a team like, you know, they've been reached out to by one or two teams already to try and print, to help with physical prints, because people want them. Especially when it comes to survival horror games, collectors want those physically. I'm not just speaking for myself, I'm speaking for like collectors, like hardcore collectors that want physical games, not even necessarily to play, but to own, you know, like get all the horror games. They're gonna want it that way. I think maybe like Limited Run or somebody's gonna team up with them and they're gonna print physical copies eventually, if not right away at some point. So yeah, I might end up buying the game twice because if it's out later in physical edition, of course I want to get that, like a proper one. But for now, you know, I'm happy buying it digitally to support Remedy, support the game because I've been waiting for the game for so long. So all I hope right now is that it's just, if they're claiming that they want it to release like that because they want to be able to you know, not have any kinks in the game. Well, then the game better not run with any bugs or any glitches when it comes out. It better be well polished, which I think it will be. You know. kill him. He's still alive. Fight two titans here. Companies are, I feel like, are such a rush to, oh, come on, to put games out. I'll kill him. Keep using all my magic here. Charging up again. Kill him, kill him, kill him. There we go. Get that experience. No, what? No way. No way.
If it's a fight you want, you got it.
Is this just another random battle, or did I actually hit him? Oh, what are these things? Element none. So they're gonna be like, I'm gonna do prism. He's gonna do Zephyr as well, and then she's gonna do. I don't know what we're up against here. Cook and Mac wearing their Halloween outfit. It does look very Halloween-esque, doesn't it? And she's gonna do, well, formation. Plant dragon. Let's try burning this freaking thing. Strong. That was not very strong. Ah, oh, Cook died again. Alright, let me just freaking attack these beasts here. HP they have. Come on, come on, come on. Alright, no, not steel. Die. Wow. Back back to that save point over there. Finish off this fight. Die. There we go. Jeez. Alright, that should see us out here. Lay on it. Kind of close to level 20 for a couple of them. Cook's not even level 18 yet. Getting away from this sleeping thing. Let's get over here. Save it again. I'm actually going to take a really quick break, guys. I will be back. I know it's early in the stream. Let me go get something. I'll be right back. We'll play some more of this tonight. Thank you all for coming in so far. I appreciate it. Thanks again to Dev for the 23-month sub from that gentleman. And Guns of the Helghast. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Thanks for the follow as well. You guys are awesome. I'll be right back. More gaming to come. Alright, everybody, thank you so much for sticking around. Break there, just had to check on something. So we have the new Double Dragon game we've been talking about. It's coming out later this month. I don't know if I'm going to be able to play it day of release or anything. I might actually be out of town for a couple days at the end of the month, well, depending on what happens. So, but we will play that. I do want to try. I have to try to get a physical copy of that ordered or something. But as far as tonight goes, depending on how the night goes, I plan on playing at least another game tonight after this. Hopefully you guys are enjoying. Wait, where do I go now? Now I'm confused. Oh, we're supposed to do that. Okay. Hey! We did it. I'll save it again, I guess. Make sure that's good. Is everybody actually, like, healthy? Okay. I am going to get into more 360 stuff too this summer, don't worry, we're still going to be doing it throughout August, maybe a little bit into September, like some of the summer gaming stuff. September is going to be kind of like a interesting month for the channel. It's going to be busy, I'm probably going to be back at work. I'm still going to be doing as much streaming and YouTube stuff as I can. We have Starfield coming out. We have Lies of P coming out in September. Two big releases. So I'm not going to do too many other series. I might go back to other ones. We might play games like My Time at Portia, State of Decay 2, you know, Zelda. We might probably still be playing. Stuff like that, that's kind of more open-ended, or stuff that we want to try to wrap up. Maybe we'll go back to something we haven't finished. That's kind of what I'm going to do in September while we play those other big releases. Because then, obviously, we have October coming, which I'm going to do nothing but horror games, so I can't have a ton of overlap going into September. Otherwise, we'll have to take a break from said series and then finish it in November. So, yeah, it's going to be... it's a balancing act for me, September. We'll have some big releases, we'll have some fun, you know, we'll probably do more like online multiplayer stuff that month too. Probably won't start a ton of new games in September besides the new releases. And you think I should play Catwoman on Zeroween, like on Halloween itself? That's the scariest thing anybody's ever said to me. That is the horror meets it, yeah. You know, my first ever live performance of Zero, which is on the channel, I had like a year ago or something. The guy that ran the event, he's like, make sure you check out Zero is the Number on YouTube if you're a fan of Catwoman the movie. Because he had seen my channel and saw I had played Catwoman. And of course he brought that game up of all the other ones. I'm like, oh, that's just lovely. What is going on here, by the way? I think Mac's been playing a bit of Catwoman himself. Like, that's a good promotion for me, for my channel and my music. At this point, I think I need to write a song called Catwoman. Well, what are we fighting? Is this a boss? Shoot. Alright, let me see what this thing... element type, so there's nothing, element none, so I don't even know what's gonna... I'm gonna try Flare. I don't know what's gonna hurt this thing. I don't know. He's gonna do Magic Defense, I guess. I'm not sure what's gonna happen here. Energy Drain! And it heals, too. What? Well, that didn't do much. I gotta get rid of, like, one tentacle at a time here. Hashtag Zero should replay Catwoman. He's starting the movement, guys. He's got the hashtag. It's gonna come to a thing where, like, some post is gonna need, like, 3,000 likes, and then maybe I'll replay it. Catwoman for Zero Lean. Yeah. Gosh, no, I can't do that game again. There's, like, few games I can never play again. That's one of them. Catwoman. Play through, anyways. I don't think I could play through Karate Kid again either. What are the other really bad ones I played? Besides, like, well, Two Worlds 2. I don't think I could ever play that one again. Should I just do, like, a physical attack? Like, I don't really know what to do here. See if I can put an enemy to sleep. The physical does okay damage. Oh my gosh, dude. Great. I don't know. So do this. Magical attacks aren't hurting this thing that much. I got rid of one tentacle. Gotta keep bringing up my magic defense. This thing's healing constantly and getting all these magic points. Now let's try to get rid of tentacle B. With him, I'm just gonna keep doing Zephyr, I guess. Keep healing. Oh gosh, that's why. Jansen isn't getting attacked here for some reason. Well, now he is. Oh, do I have to keep Cook alive? I don't even know that.
Cook!
No. Oh, I didn't know I had to, like... Can I heal Cook? Or do I just have to beat him before he steals all of her health? That'll be ridiculous. Because I don't know, like, what this thing's weak against. I mean, they're not kidding. This is really hard in the beginning of the game. Like, this first disc is a... Like, this is, like, crazy. Let me see. I have to, like, grind a bit again. We'll see, though. So we're still going to play, like, Shaun White Skateboarding. I promise that game, I want to play it. We will be playing that one. And NCAA Football 14 Season 2, along with this. I've already done Gears of War and Cameo, and one or two other 360 games for a night. Falling Skies. So I've done some. If I could hit another 360 game, I will. I'll do one more. I think this game's going to take us into September for sure. There's no way I'm going to have this done by the end of August. Not sure if I can heal her, so I have to beat him before he kills her. Oh man. How? Like, I got like so many things to attack here. I have to have everybody attack, man. Let's just all focus on Tentacle A. What can he do that might hurt it? How about ground? I don't know. Can I attack the tentacle that's holding her, maybe? She already lost a bunch of health. Alright, that's one down. I'm gonna see if I can heal Cook. I cannot. Oh my gosh. Alright. From her. That's fine. 36 damage. I'll live with that all day. Damn, it stole so much more. Alright, I'm gonna have her attack C. Oh, the one that she's... Oh, okay. I probably need to kill that one. Damn it. Alright. Let's hit that one. Nope. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Shoot. Screwed up. That didn't do any damage. Oh my gosh. Oh, good. Alright, so ground deals a lot of damage on that one. Let me do it. Just to make sure this thing freaking dies there. Alright. I'm gonna need to heal soon. Come on, Jansen. I'm gonna get rid of that one. Wow. Still not doing anything. Only two? Okay, I can't be doing that. That's a waste of a turn. G. Jeez, that tentacle has way more HP than any other one. Still 30. She's still alive with 5. We need to finish it off this time. But then we gotta probably fight the main part of this entity after we get rid of their tentacles. Wow, that one's not dying. Oh, there we go. You're barely alive, Cook, but you're alive. Get out of there. Join the team with your 5 HP. Keep going, team. Come on. I'll have her do Zephyr. I'll have him do Zephyr as well. Have her. Speed that up. Alright, okay. So then get the heals in, come on. Start attacking this thing. There we go, there we go. Okay, now. Just watch him fall. Damn it, Mac. There's always some kid that gets himself in trouble, huh? All you have to do is stay with us. This never would happen. Now we gotta fight Mac. Have some of this, Mac. Let me just keep attacking him for now. Shoot, I'm killing him. Damn it. I didn't know. It would have been nice to tell me before I had started attacking him. I suppose we can't go the rest of the game without him. So I have to like put him to sleep maybe? I don't know, my gosh, now we gotta do it all over again. It's annoying. It's like already locked into my moves, I didn't know. It'd be nice if it like told you that before you went. So we got the idea. I hope that's the idea, is to put him to sleep. I don't know what else to do. Paralyze him maybe? Alright, so yeah, we can attack the one tentacle. We'll try, and hopefully we'll get it this time. Hopefully. Da-da-da-da. Skip that. Let me We have to focus on the one that's grabbing her right away. Which is C. Oh no. They did it twice? Come on. It knows that we're going after it now. I wonder if his regular attack will be alright against it. Hers is not. Try flare. Bad. Yeah. Parasitic worm? Yeah, does it? Like a ringworm or something. Now we're gonna need some healing. We gotta get Cook back. On powering up again. Oh, no. Man, don't kill anybody, please. I'm about to heal. No! Alright, we got her. Good. Okay. Tentacle kitty. This is, I had a feeling somebody was gonna bring it there. You know, there's a comic called Tentacle Kitty. It's really weird. My friend and I, like, saw it. I'm like, what the hell is this? What the hell is this? Tentacle Kitty, yeah. Strange. I'm okay with that idea. Alright, but I guess, yeah, we'll just keep working on whatever one. Keep using, magic. She's gonna do Zephyr, I guess. Seth died? Oh man. I definitely have to get Seth back. Yeah, it's very weird. I couldn't tell you what it's about. I just I'm like, what is this? I need him to bring back Seth. He's gonna have to do Zephyr. She only has white magic, huh? survive this. Not safe for work, yeah. You don't know what's gonna come up if you Google that. Seth too weak, abandoned him right now. I know, Seth dies and like, I don't know, like Kaim's always the strongest character. I need to get some more offense in here. But I have to keep healing. Shoot, you know what? I have to kill at least one of these tentacles. I'll have her do Zephyr. I know he can do. Tentacle B will start working on too. There we go. Lead them as a sacrifice to the parasite monster, yeah. Like, we're good. Seth died again before I could heal her. Oh, well, how are we doing worse this time? Like, I got Cook into the fight early and we're doing worse. I don't know what's going on. And nothing now. Seth. Jeez. I could try to bring her back. I gotta use up my last angel plume for that. Gosh. It's like then I'm left like not being able to attack anything. Seth this. Oh wait, I can't. Not yet. Okay.
Okay.
She's gonna die again. Watch this. Almost. She's gonna die right here. Can't get her back. How did I do worse this time? Don't get it. This thing. She shouldn't have run her mouth. Except she's all talk, no game here. Alright, we got to this again. Now let's try to put him to sleep, I guess. But are my moves already locked in? Oh no, alright. Go to sleep, kid. Just in case that doesn't work. What? Oh, Cook's dead too. Damn. Wait, now what? Inflicting fear on my guy. What do I do here? I can't attack Mac, right? I didn't mean to do that. Just wasted one. Do I just continue putting him to sleep, or? Not sure. Very depressing. Freaking Seth. Do I attack him now that he's asleep? I'm so confused. Like, there's nothing else I can focus on but Mac, and is there anything that can cure him from... I'm gonna try paralyzing him again? I don't know. I'll just have him attack that just to see if that does anything. Jansen's terrorized. So we can't paralyze him. I mean, I gotta also cure. Cure all. Very confused here. So to just like survive until this thing decides to go away? I have no idea. This is really strange. By attacking him again. Missed. not supposed to kill Mac. Cure his fear. Using up a lot of items here, like, because I don't really know what works. What is a Kello vitamin? I don't even know, like, what a Kelonian Kelolon even is. One. What the hell? I don't know what it does. Okay. What do I even do? I have nothing that can cure the fear anymore. I don't freaking know. If you could target him, then he isn't asleep. Oh, I just read that one. Thank you, Mitsa. So I still need to put him to sleep? Oh my gosh. Alright. I need any mana. There's no way I can get mana back either. This is... Go to sleep. Use half my magic points on one move here. Right, now he's asleep? Okay, this is all very weird, what's going on here. One damage? But I can't cure our status ailment because there's nothing. There's no magic for that. Against him. Wind bomb did some damage. That did not. It's not going good at all. Now Mac's asleep again. Great. Or Mac's awake, I should say. One health? Why? Uh, like, oh, I'm running out of stuff. Like, why is it? It's making me use all my magic points. I don't only have so many to use here. This is a very strange fight. I don't know what to say about this one. Like, okay, now I can attack him again? I'm gonna lose because I don't really know.
Okay.
It works, so it doesn't work. Any stuff that doesn't inflict fear on me. That was the end of that. How about an Aqua Bomb? Healing herb, I guess, and I'll do.
Okay.
Did 142. Oh, he's awake again. Good morning, Mac. I have no magic to put you to sleep again, so. I guess I'll just use a healing medicine on Jansen. I can't put him to sleep now, so I have to throw in the towel because I don't have any items left? That's not fair. I have no way of replenishing my magic points. This is stupid. Magic points back. I don't know what this Kello vitamin even did. I didn't do anything. What do I do? Like, if you're out of magic points and items to replenish your magic, you're screwed here. You're basically soft locked in the attack. And that's so stupid. All because he just keeps going to sleep. And you have to use your magic points to attack this stupid thing. What am I to do? It's gonna let him kill me. There's nothing else I can do. Waste of time. There's a ring that if you attack, you get a few MP, so I need to wear that ring. See, I didn't know it was all this. Let me see. Oh, I see, thank you. This might save us yet. Actually, I'm gonna equip it to... equip it to Jansen because he has more MP, so if we're still alive. There we go. That's a big help, Mitsa. We just gotta stay alive now. I use Kaim to heal him. And what can he do? And I'll defend again.
Okay.
Make sure he stays alive. Okay, he will just defend, and then he will do sleep. Stay asleep now. It's such a crazy play, I don't know. A lot of back and forth here. Alright, now Aqua Bomb. Hey, Jansen to defend again.
Okay.
Here's my last Aqua Bomb here. I'll have him defend. Get a little bit more.
Okay.
Now we need to flare bomb? I don't know. You heal us.
Okay.
We did it. Unbelievable. That would have been a huge waste of time if we didn't do it. Thanks to Mitsa with the ring. That really helped us. I was like, there's gotta be a way that we can get some MP back. What a fight that was. Thank you guys. Now don't you run off again, Matt. Yeah, that was so satisfying. I think we all wanted to slap him right there. Cook's my favorite character now. She's like, bitch!
People die, they just go away. If there's any place a soul would go, it's in your memories. People you remember are with you forever. Lyrum will continue to live on in our memories. And that's a good thing, right?
Yeah.
Let's return these flowers to where they belong.
Oh. I like that Crimson Forest. That was probably my favorite area of the game so far. We blame you, Seth. We still blame you. We're gonna be hopping on the Series X next, guys. This music's awesome.
Crimson
You weren't 5 minutes ago, Meg. Preparing to change disc. Would you like to save your game first? Yes, I would. All right, that's the end of disc one. Wow. Okay. Took us like 11 and a half hours or so of game time to get through that. All right. Dang, likes me too. We did it. I got through disc one. I'm not gonna go too far, much further than this. I'm just gonna get to like the first kind of save point here on disc two. Then we'll switch. But hey, that's good. That's good progress now. Each boss fight's been pretty difficult so far. I mean, the first one, the monster dragon, whatever, was actually the easiest we've had to deal with so far, I would say. I'm guessing each disc is going to take us roughly 10 to 15 hours. Yeah, we're looking at probably around 50 hours at this game, I think, guys. Which is fine. Should be a nice journey. I think this is going to go down as a classic. Oh, we're back here. Is this where we're supposed to be? Let's go to this. Yeah, I guess we'll wrap up this part here in a little over 2 hours. We'll switch games tonight. At least we come back, we'll get going into disc two. Moving along in this game pretty nicely. I would say it's like the bosses are hard, but once you like kind of learn what to do, you can get through them. This hasn't really required that much grinding yet. Like, we've gotten in fights, it's kind of been good at that. You know, I hate like having to sit and grind for hours and hours just to progress like main stuff. I think a lot of grinding and stuff like that should be optional if you want to like superpower yourself up. Which again, I don't mind doing time to time in some RPGs, you guys know that. I will take time to get some higher levels here and there, but yeah, this one hasn't been too bad so far. It is hard, but it's doable so far. It's not like impossible. And we really haven't done that much grinding, just a little bit. We've pretty much naturally progressed through the areas, getting into the fights that we are only have to get into. So, and thanks to help from you guys, especially Mita, giving me a lot of help with this game so far. Anthony and others. And hey guys, hope you guys enjoyed more Lost Odyssey tonight. I appreciate those that watch. Thank you so much.